Okay, hello students. So today in this video we are going to discuss about the chairman powers and duties. Okay, before going into the detail about the powers and duties of a chairman, who is a chairman? What is the role of a chairman in the company? We'll see. Okay, so we know that the main important company is an artificial in nature where it cannot do anything on its own. So because of that, there is an human agents who are being called as in the directors. Yes or no? So the directors are going to be appointed for a board of director and directors, a head need to be there. Yes or no? So to control the conduct or affairs of an organization, whether the directors are going to perform well or not, it is need to be taken care by at least one person. Yes. So that one person is known as an chairman. Okay. So we have been seen in the meetings, board of directors are going to be conducted different meetings, in the shareholders meeting, statutory meeting, AGM, EGM, class meeting, board of directors meeting, whatever it might be. So it all are need to be held under the guidance of a chairman. He is the person who is going to take care all of us or take care complete conduct and behavior of an directors and whether they are going to perform well or not as per the rules and regulations are going to be checked by the chairman itself. So chairman is an executive elected by an companies. He is a chairman, he is a person who is going to be elected by the company's board of directors. That is, all the directors in the board of all the directors who are going to be elected, this one particular person who is responsible for conducting the board meetings, So he's a person who heads the board of directors. Just now I told, for the complete directors in the organization, he acts as an head of the board of directors. Okay, so he's called as an chairman. So here same the chairman, he also one of the director, and among the he's also one of the director. He is going to be appointed as by having a majority of an votes. Who if one nominee gets a majority of an votes, then they he or she is going to be elected as an chairman. And a removal of an chairman. So if other directors in the board of committee, they can fire or they can remove the particular chairman from that particular position. So if a chairman is not having he is just lacking the ability of an leadership qualities, or else he's having a interest of conflicts, anything illegal affairs, so obviously the directors can fire the particular chairman. And here a chairman, that is a tenure of a chairman, is not going to be permanent. Depends on the organization. A chairman elected by members of a board for a fixed period of time. So the chairman is going to be elected for a fixed period of time. For example, he can be elected for 1 year, he can be elected for 2 years. It depends. Okay, so it depends on the particular organization. So he shall preside over all the meetings of the organization during his tenure, during his period. Okay, so this is about the introduction of a chairman, and we'll see what are his main powers and duties of a chairman. So powers of a chairman. The chairman presides over the meeting of a company. The chairman has to decide priority of a speaker, that is who should speak first and who should follow. So he is having a he can decide the priority of a speaker, that's the, who is going to speak first, who is going to follow. He can decide that. And the next is chairman of a meeting has power to stop discussion on any matter after it has been reasonably debated. Suppose in the meeting sometimes we'll be seeing rather than talking, it becomes like an it turns into us in a debate, right? So in that situation, he's having a right to stop that particular discussion of the hot matter. Okay, so and the next one is the chairman has the power to put motion and amendments there to ought by show of hands and first hands first and properly demand by the poll. So he is having a right to amend, to change, to modify any kind of particular system in the meeting. Either it could be in the type of voting system, whether to show the hands and properly demand by the poll, whatever it might be. He is having a right or he is having a power to amend their oaths. And the next is the chairman can adjourn the meeting if the quorum is not present. So we have been discussed, quorum plays a vital role. A minimum number need to be there, right? So in case of a private company, 2 members need to be there. In case of a public company, 3 to 15 members need to be there based on the numbers, right? So here also a proper quorum need to be there. If there is no proper quorum, he is having a power to stop the meeting or to not to hold the particular meeting. And the next is chairman has a power to maintain order decorum at a meeting. And the next is the chairman has a power to give a ruling on interpretations of rules, and his ruling will be binding on the members. So these are the powers of a chairman. And the next is duties of a chairman. He must act as honestly. Honesty is the best policy. This is what always we say. Yes or no? So he need to act honestly in the at the time of conducting the meeting, at whatever the directors have been designed the plan, whether it is going to be implemented, whatever it might be, he need to be very honest. And the next is he must check whether business transactions are taken as per agenda. So agenda, according to that, if he need to check whether it is going to be done on the decided agenda or not. His duty is to give sufficient opportunity. So it is the responsibility of a chairman that all the members need to talk. Equal opportunity need to be given for all the speakers. In case of an equality of an oaths, it is the duty of a chairman to exercise casting vote followed by the articles. So whatever the, in case of a tie, so according to the articles of association, he need to follow the rules and regulations. If the duty of a chairman, whether minutes of meeting properly entered, confirmed and duly signed by him. So minutes, important discussions, important points and need to be noted down, right? So whether it is he need to check whether it has been properly entered, confirmed, and he need to sign on that particular document. Okay, so these are the duties of a chairman. Okay, done. Thank you.